Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Jeff Christensen. I'm the Vice President of Operations at Spears. On behalf of the Foord family, I want to thank you all, first of all, for coming. We wanted to make a few brief announcements before the worship service begins so that they don't need to be made afterwards. You are a large crowd, and they're grateful for your presence, and they want you to stay and spend some time with them afterwards. But the education here, center here at Christ Lutheran is quite a bit smaller than the sanctuary. So we just want to give some simple instructions about how things will proceed afterwards. We'll give the family a little bit of an opportunity to leave after the concluding hymn has been sung. They will immediately go to the education center, serve themselves, and take their seats. We'd encourage you just to wait a moment or two, not a long time. But then as you exit, those who are staying, we encourage you to begin to go to the education center right away. Serve yourself. Consider the food blessed by the time we're spending together and by God's presence with us now. And go ahead and find a seat. When there are no more seats upstairs, you may serve yourself. You may come sit back in the sanctuary. There is some space with tables downstairs in the education center, and either the Christ Lutheran serving family or our staff will direct you to those spots. Here in the sanctuary, the photos you've been seeing before the service will be playing again, along with some of Christel's favorite music. So there's lots of space in the room for in the building for everyone to gather. You just may not all find a seat upstairs, okay? And please don't be discouraged by that. Be patient. They really want you to stay and enjoy some time together with them, sharing stories and comforting each other with your presence. So again, thank you all for coming.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. I invite the gathering to please stand as you are able as Christel's family enters and we join in the singing of our processional hymn, which is Lord, Take My Hand and Lead Me. It is printed in our service inserts. Gathering to please be seated. I'm Pastor Jeff Tank, and on behalf of Christel's family, I welcome you who are joining with us here in person, as well as those who are joining us online today for the service. Welcome to all of you in the name of Jesus, Christel's Savior and friend, whose life on earth showed us the face of God's embracing love. It's an understatement to say that as we gather here today, how difficult and painful a time this is for all of us. As we think about the special times and the seasons we've shared with Christel, this beloved child of God, who now we're missing so deeply. And we hope that together we can find an experience of some healing and peace and comfort in being in each other's presence. I begin by lifting up one of the promises that Christel found her hope in. St. Paul reminds us, when we were baptized into Christ Jesus, we were baptized into his death. We were buried, therefore, with him by baptism into death, so that as Christ was raised from the dead by the glory of God, we too might find a new life. For if we have been united with him in a death like his, we will certainly be reunited with him in a resurrection like his. Christel was a follower of Jesus all the days of her life. Right from a little girl. Faith was important to her, and she certainly lived her faith. We saw that in so many ways. And that meant she took also people the way they came. And she loved people, whether they were Christian or not. So today, as you gather here in this gathering of diversity of friends, know that no matter where you come from, what you believe, what you don't believe, in the spirit of God's loving embrace, you are so welcome here. And we are so thankful that each and every one of you have gathered here to spend this time together this day to comfort Ron and his family in their grief and comfort each other in our grief. We continue in faith, hope, and love, praying the prayers as we're comfortable to pray them, to join in as you feel comfortable and called. We find the gathering prayer, the opening gathering prayer, in our service folder. The Lord be with you. We pray. Eternal God, you gave your breath of life to Christel, creating her as your child. You then entrusted her to us to know and to love. As we thank you for the life we shared, help us now to release her to your gentle keeping. Bring us all to that day when we shall have joy in your presence, surrounded by all your saints in light eternal, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. At this time, the family have prepared some personal thoughts, memories, thanksgiving to share with us. And I'd invite nephew Evan Duravel and daughter Lindsay Shaw to come and share their reflections with us here in from this space.
Hello, everyone. My name is Evan Duravel. I am Christel's nephew and godson.
And my name is Lindsay Shaw, and I'm Christel's daughter, and because I'm up here, I can say that I'm the favorite, so they can't do anything about it over there.
We want to first of all extend our gratitude to all the relatives, friends, and attendees gathered here to honor this phenomenal woman, Christel Monica Foord, a person we have all come to love and cherish over many years. Along the Quapel Valley, 20 minutes north of Regina on the Pelzer family farm is where Christel's story begins. On March 14th, 1962, Wilhelm and Mary Pelzer completed their family of five with the birth of their youngest daughter, Christel Monica Pelzer. Her older siblings, Anne-Marie and Edmund, were very excited when Christel was born. The cornerstones of Christel's life were built on the family farm. She was a farm girl at heart. Her work ethic, appreciation of nature, adventurous spirit, love of languages, travel and cultures, and most notably her deeply rooted beliefs in service to others began on the farm. In the Pelzer home, the first language spoken was and sung was German. Christel was incredibly proud of her German heritage. When she was 2 years old, Opa and Oma packed up their family and drove across Canada to Montreal to board a ship sailing for Germany. For the next 3 months, the Pelzer family traveled throughout Europe. This was the beginning of Christel's passion for travel. Both traveling and exploring the world ran deep through her soul. Christel began to travel the world as early as 12 years old, when she flew to Germany on her own to visit family and friends. She definitely was an influence on me wanting to see different places and cultures. After Auntie Christel and Uncle Ron, or my wife Kathy and I would return from a trip somewhere, we would always share our experiences, good or bad, to know if we would like to travel there again. These conversations typically went through everything in exact detail, pretty much becoming like a travel show critique. Christel attended and graduated with distinction from Scott Collegiate. After graduation, she backpacked Europe as well as working and traveling through Australia. She was not happy unless she was traveling or planning to travel. Christel explored many options for her future career and decided to become a radiation therapist. This program, based in Saskatoon, was highly sought after, fully funded program that only accepted 4 students every 2 years. It was no surprise to those who knew and loved Christel that she was among the 4 selected. Throughout her career, she fulfilled many roles, from therapist to manager. Every patient and coworker was impacted by her profound, compassionate nature. She took many therapists under her wings for guidance and support and was the driving force shaping the clinic to what it is today. Her inclusive nature to all coworkers is endeared in everyone's hearts, a true advocate for patient-centered care, and she was never afraid to speak up for those patients. Christel was the first point of contact often for family and friends and wherever there was a medical question or emergency, as well as a confidant to many. Her gentle spirit and loving nature comforted many times in crisis during the late night phone calls. Wherever Christel lived, she became an active member of the community. While she lived in Calgary throughout the late 80s, she created lifelong friendships. She sang in the 1988 Winter Olympics opening ceremonies, sang with the German Ladies Choir, and coached a Little League team. And a memory for me while she lived in Calgary was Opa and Oma took my sister Maria and I on a summer road trip to visit. We were there for over a week and had befriended a kid at the local park who proceeded to have us helping him light matches and trying to start fires at the playground. The one day, Auntie Christel ended up coming to the park and catching us. Her reaction was very calm and collected. She made it more of a learning situation than a scolding. And looking back, I always knew she would be a great mother. Shortly after her move to Calgary, Christel felt the urge to explore the world once again. She made the bold move to apply for a position at the King Faisal Hospital in Riyadh, Saudi Arabia, where she spent 2.5 years as a radiation therapist. Christel used Saudi Arabia as her home base. She would return to Canada once a year to share her adventures and then return to Saudi to explore other parts of the world. There were many letters and postcards exchanged during her time in the Middle East. Christel's adventurous spirit continued while she lived in Saudi Arabia. She played baseball in the desert and grew her love and collection of gold jewelry. During the Gulf War, while Christel was holed up in a bathroom during an airstrike raid, she decided it may be time for a new adventure. This move brought her closer to home, landing in Victoria, BC, where she continued work as a radiation therapist. While Victoria was beautiful and gave Christel the opportunity to live close to the ocean, shortly thereafter, she returned to her roots in Regina. Christel's passport has been stamped in Europe several times, where she spent a great deal of time visiting family and friends in Germany. She also has backpacked throughout Thailand and more recently biked through Holland. She had other traveling adventures in the Southern Hemisphere, where she drove through Australia and New Zealand. In recent years, she had the opportunity to travel to Switzerland and South Korea to watch curling and be a support to her family. When Christel wasn't traveling, she was skiing in the mountains, and not long ago skied a double black diamond in Revelstoke. Ultimately, her slice of paradise was at the family cabin at Buffalo Pound Lake. Christel loved going to the cabin to unwind and relax. She could often be sitting on the deck or floating in the water with a glass of wine in hand. While Christel explored many parts of the world, her smile always shone brighter than the sun when she was near the beach and the ocean. Every warm holiday was documented with a picture of her beautiful feet in the sand. Barbados and Mexico were among her favorite hot destinations. You could basically say sunshine was her favorite color. Christel shared her love of travel with those close to her and never passed up the opportunity to make new connections. Her family and friendships were her greatest treasure. Thank you.
So some may say that traveling the world was Christel's greatest adventure. However, in the early 90s, when Christel returned to live in Regina, little did she know she was about to embark on the wildest and most fulfilling adventure of her lifetime as a wife and mother. In 1991, Christel met a man who self-proclaimed to be cheap and not like jewelry. For some, that may seem like a red flag, but for Christel, she saw a man that would hold and protect her for all the days of her life. My dad, Ron Foord, loves Christel fiercely and beautifully. When Dad brought Christel into our lives, she shared her love of travel with us, with my sisters Teddy and Paige and I. Whether it was on top of a ski hill, on a beach, or at the lake floating behind the boat, Christel shared her adventurous spirit with us. There is one memory in particular that is fondly recalled around our kitchen table. In the early days of Dad and Crystal's relationship, they decided to take us to the mountains to ski for the first time. We loaded up her little white compact four-door Shadow and headed out. Christel had no room in the front seat to move at all because she had treats packed around her feet. We sang Sharon, Lois, and Bram all the way to the mountains. It wasn't a fancy or extravagant trip, but we were experiencing life together. For our family, family time is always the best time. A few years later, Dad and Christel got married on a sunny day in April and honeymooned in Barbados. This trip began a long-standing tradition of yearly trips back to Barbados. Their special love and love of travel became so well known among the locals that they were featured in a travel magazine titled Love Keeps Bringing Them Back. Over the years, Dad and Christel shared their love of Barbados in various locations around the world with many family and friends. Christel very well could have been a travel agent in her former life. Christel was well known for her generosity, nurturing spirit, and patience. My sisters and I believe that these qualities were all in preparation for the biggest and best blessing in her life, her pride and joy, and my best brother, Isaac. In 1999, Isaac was born. My sisters and I begged for a brother. We knew that we would love Isaac and that he would be a special person. What we didn't know at the time was that he would be the piece of our family puzzle that connected us as a solid unit. It is hard to put into words the depth of Christel's love for Isaac. She loved being his mom, and she loved showing him the world. As a matter of fact, on one of their yearly trips back to Barbados, Christel enrolled Isaac in a local school, just for one day. And then her and Dad peeked through the school windows, anxiously watching to see how it all unfolded. Christel also loved to watch Isaac explore new sports, and it always amazed me that whatever sport Isaac was interested in or playing, she always knew all the rules and all the ins and outs of the game. Whether Christel was biking through Holland, sitting through a snow or rainstorm on the sidelines of a Thunder game, or hosting a meal for his friends, she was always his number one fan. Over the last several years, we've added to our family with son-in-laws and grandchildren. Both additions have brought more love and laughter to our family. Christel treasured her connection with her grandkids. Special meals, snuggles, and dance parties are common at Grandma and Papa's house. Most recently, Race started lifting weights with Papa and Isaac, which now we have come to learn that he came for the weightlifting, but really stayed because Grandma was making his favorite meal after with special desserts ready as soon as they were done. After Beckett found out that Grandma was making supper after the weightlifting, he all of a sudden began to take an interest in weightlifting as well. Last summer, Beckett got some special one-on-one time out at the cabin with Papa and Grandma, and she loved her time out at the lake with Beckett and often spoke about how much she enjoyed being with him out there one-on-one. Sloan and Grandma loved playing games, matching their clothes, and playing the piano together. Grandma loved getting FaceTime calls from the Heberts. Griff loved it when Papa and Grandma would come to Alberta to cheer on the Thunder and cuddle up to watch a movie. Grandma was the expert cuddler and has slow danced many of our babies to sleep. The latest addition to our family, Foord, was no exception. Fordy spent many afternoons dancing, snapping, clapping, and singing with Grandma. She's got this great little head bob that we're pretty sure Christel taught her how to do. These special times were cherished by Grandma. Christel took every opportunity to explore life to the fullest. She was an active participant in life regardless of her location in the world. She was part of so many communities wherever she lived. And in recent years, Christel began going to the gym. She was so proud of her efforts, and Dad was so proud of her 5 a.m. workouts. Her dedication to fitness gave her strength to explore her surroundings, whether it was bike riding, downhill or cross-country skiing, golf, baseball, or running around the lake with Dad. Whether it was at home or abroad, it really didn't matter what activity they were doing as long as they were doing it together. Christel collected a lot of mementos throughout her travels. Sea glass and seashells, rocks and jewelry, pottery, trinkets, tablecloths for every occasion, beautiful napkins, candles, boarding passes, and passport stamps, adventures and memories. However, her greatest treasure was her family and friends. Christel deeply loved her people, and her people deeply love her. She genuinely wanted those around her to be happy. She made it her personal goal on several occasions to help others find happiness or to bring joy into their lives. It may have been with a thoughtful note, a beautiful plant, a phone call of reassurance, or if you were really lucky, a lemon meringue pie dropped off at school to brighten your day. Christel lived her life in service to others. She never asked for anything in return or to be recognized for her efforts. She simply wished for others to be happy. Christel was the best of us, and her presence in our lives will forever be a treasured gift.
Thank you so much, Evan and Lindsay. Family has put together a picture presentation that we can enjoy at this time.
This morning, smile with the rising sun. Three little birds beat by my doorstep, singing sweet songs of melodies pure and true, saying,
this is my message to you, woo-hoo.
Singing, don't worry about a thing.
take me the way I am. I'd buy you Rogaine when you start losing all your hair, so on patches to all you tear, 'cause I
to see the person I have become. Spread your wings, and I know that when God took you back, He said, hallelujah, you're home.
After seeing those beautiful pictures, we're here, the person who we're here to honor and give thanks for, we now hear words of scripture that the family's chosen to speak into our hearts, a word of hope and love and comfort in this day that's not easy. I'd invite, for our first reading, Christel's niece, Maria Ritz, to come forward for the lesson.
This is the reading from Romans, chapter 12, verses 9 through 12. Let love be genuine. Hate what is evil. Hold fast to what is good. Love one another with mutual affection. Outdo one another in showing honor. Do not lag in zeal. Be ardent in spirit. Serve the Lord. Rejoice in hope. Be patient in suffering. Persevere in prayer. Contribute to the needs of the saints. Extend hospitality to strangers. Here ends the reading.
The psalm for our service today is Psalm 139. It's about the God that goes everywhere with us, all travels. O Lord, you have searched me and known me. You know when I sit down and when I rise up. You discern my thoughts from far away. You search out my path and my lying down. You're acquainted with all my ways. Even before a word is on my tongue, O Lord, you know it completely. You hem me in, behind and before. You lay your hand upon me. Such knowledge is so wonderful for me. It is so high that I cannot attain it. For where can I go from your spirit? Where can I flee from your presence? If I ascend to heaven, you are there. If I make my bed in the place of the dead, there you are. If I take the wings of the morning and settle at the farthest limits of the sea, even there your hand shall lead me, your right hand holding me fast. This time, niece Kristen Pelzer will have our second lesson.
A reading from Paul's first letter to the church at Corinth. If I speak in the tongues of mortals and of angels, but do not have love, I am a noisy gong or a clanging cymbal. And if I have prophetic powers and understand all mysteries and all knowledge, and if I have all faith so as to remove mountains, but do not have love, I am nothing. If I give away all my possessions, and if I hand over my body so that I may boast, but do not have love, I gain nothing. Love is patient. Love is kind. Love is not envious or boastful, or arrogant or rude. It does not insist on its own way. It is not irritable or resentful. It does not rejoice in wrongdoing, but rejoices in the truth. It bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, and endures all things. Love never ends, but as for prophecies, they will come to an end. As for tongues, they will cease. As for knowledge, it will come to an end. For we know only in part, and we prophesy only in part. But when the complete comes, the partial will come to an end. For now we see in a mirror, dimly, but then we will see face to face. Now I know only in part, then I will know fully, even as I have been fully known. And now faith, hope, and love abide, these three, and the greatest of these is love. This is the word of the Lord.
I invite you to remain seated, please, as we listen for the gospel. That's gospel according to St. Luke, reading today from the sixth chapter. These are words of teaching from Jesus that come right after the well-known Beatitudes or the blessings from the Sermon on the Mount. Here Jesus says, "But I say to you that listen, love your enemies, do good to those who hate you, bless those who curse you, even pray for those who abuse you. If anyone strikes you on the cheek, offer the other also, and from anyone who takes away your coat, do not withhold even your shirt. Give to everyone who begs from you, and if anyone takes away your goods, do not ask for them again. Do to others as you would have them do to you. If you love those who love you, what credit is that to you? Even sinners love those who love them. If you do good to those who do good to you, what credit is that to you? For even sinners do the same. If you lend to those who from whom you hope to receive, what credit is that to you? Even sinners lend to sinners to receive as much again. But I say this to you, love your enemies, do good and lend, expecting nothing in return, for your reward will be great, for you are children of the Most High, and God is kind to the ungrateful and even to the wicked. Be merciful just as your God in heaven is merciful." And I'd add just a short reading from the gospel according to John, the 14th chapter, where Jesus is nearing the end of his life in the last week of his life. And he says this to his friends who he'll be leaving behind. He says, "I will not leave you orphaned. I am coming to you. In a little while, the world will no longer see me, but you will see me, and because I live, you too shall live. On that day, you will know that I am in the Father, and you in me, and I in you. My peace I leave with you. My peace I give to you. I do not give you as the world gives. Do not let your hearts be troubled. Do not let them be afraid." Let us pray. Speak to us now, O God of life, and wherever our hearts and minds are in this moment and in these days, somehow bring joy to your children again. Amen. So, first of all, to Ron, to Isaac, Lindsay, Teddy, Paige, to your families, to Mum Mary, and to Sister Anne and Brother Edmund, and all your families, and all the rest of you who are gathered here today, dear family and friends, again, my deepest condolences, and know that our prayers for healing surround you in these hard days. Let's do a little bit more focusing on Christel, just for a moment. Return to that. Recapping maybe a little bit, but thinking again about this woman being a lover, a teacher, an ultimate fan of her children and grandchildren, a person who took charge of, could we say, a rascal of a husband sometimes, I'm sure, person she loved so dearly, a partner, Ron, enjoying trips to Barbados, again, wherever in the world the plane or the boat took her. Christel, a person, again, who we know made time for us, time for others, spending time with friends in so many places and in groups and communities, bringing laughter and a listening ear, engaging in great conversations with family and friends alike, whether at church. I met her at Trinity Lutheran 27 years ago. All the other places that she found herself, home, work, play, those places. caring for people as a radiation therapist again, and you might say again, a professional comforter in her role, caring for and about others always, and hoping for peace, joy, and a spirit of gentleness to find its way out from her, spilling out into the world, living for the sake of others. We know that Christel wasn't the Christ, she wasn't the Savior. She knew that, but the Spirit of God shone out brightly in her life and from her life, right up to that very sudden, unexpected heart episode which took her from us. And now we are here together to share our sadness and to comfort each other in our pain, but also to continue in a way with that legacy of caring and hope, which was Christel's gift and remains Christel's gift to us. And I believe that remains a gift because Christel lived out a story that cradled, out of the story that cradled her life and held her life and continues to hold her in this very moment. And again, I'd return that that is the story of her faith, of God who didn't come ever to bring suffering or pain, but who came in Jesus to share our frail humanity. Christ is that God who has lived and experienced the spectrum of suffering, from suffering on the one hand, right through the rainbow to the other side, where there is this incredible gift of sharing joy that we have when we are compassionate, caring human beings to one another. And then ultimately, God promises to be with us right into our ending, what seems to be our ending, and to deliver us to the reign and kingdom of God, where a deep, everlasting peace envelops us. But there are times, like the time we are in right now, that none of us can escape, where it's hard to see or believe that it's ever going to be okay again. We all come to those places in our lives at different times. Or that peace can come, or joy, how can it come when we can lose people so quickly like we've lost Christel? How can this happen, and what do we do now? 3 days after the death of their friend Jesus, the disciples, his loved ones, gathered in a house, again, maybe in a state of shock, of sadness, of wondering about the future, wondering just how they were going to get it all together at that point. And maybe this afternoon, again, it's easy for us to relate to that group. For Jesus' family and his friends 2,000 years ago, like it has perhaps been for your family this week, it's been one of those weeks that no one wanted to deal with, just heartbreak. Again, the crucifixion in this case had happened. Now they were trying to figure out what it all meant. For family and friends to be together in a time of sorrow means so much. And it's one way to start that healing to progress. Again, I'm sure that it's been like that for your family, a little bit like that for each one of us. Everyone deals with death and our significant losses in different ways. Family and friends of Jesus were no different. The Bible tells stories of how some couldn't handle it and they just ran away. That's all they could do at the time. And then there was others that just needed to be alone for a short time. And then there were those who came together again with all sorts of feelings. Some were really angry. Some were incredibly sad and lonely. Others were fearful. Some in shock, some still being numb. But everyone was hurt and drained. And yet again, what was really hopeful after those 3 days after Jesus' death was there was people that did come together for each other and put their arms around each other and offered support to each other. That's what I've seen with this family in this very, very difficult time, and through friends now who gather around you here in this place behind closed doors. And I think part of Christel's life gift to you again is that she embodied what Paul was talking about in the book of Romans. Love one another with mutual affection. Rejoice with those who rejoice. Weep with those who weep. Live peaceably with all. It's part of her beautiful witness to us about how to go forward right now. And it is for me a powerful thing to witness again when a family comes together in hard times, with a sense of compassion and love and even a bit of humor and lifting each other's spirits. We know that when love has been shared and the pain comes naturally, when death comes to try to place a barrier between us and what goes on before us, again, it was the same for Jesus' followers as it was for us today. But the story of the gospel is the story of Jesus' death, life, death, and resurrection. The promises come like this. When you think that it's over, when you think that that pain has the final word, when you feel perhaps utterly alone right now, God, the creator of life and love and new days, comes promising to be there for you, comes promising to carry Christel to you again. It's hard to hold on to that hope right now. Christel attended lots of services just like this one for family and friends, said goodbye to a lot of dear friends and people that she loved, but her faith is not in vain. And one day, as the gospel tells us, there are many rooms in the mansion of God, a feast being prepared before us, a time when sunshine will break through again, and all will be well. All manner of things will be well. In this hard time, again, we continue to surround you with our love, all you family and friends of Christel. Pray for you. We ask God to mend our broken hearts and carry us until that day we look forward to meeting our sister again, as she's cared for in God's kingdom until that time that we can be together. God bless you and keep you until that day. Amen. Christel placed trust in her baptismal promises that she is always God's child. Nothing can like that can take or change that. We have a baptismal hymn that we sing at this time. We'll remain seated as we sing it. It's found in our bulletins. I'd invite us now to join together praying to the merciful, loving God. And I'll close each petition of the prayers saying, Lord, in your mercy, I invite you to make the prayer your own with the response, hear our prayer. Let us pray. Most gracious God, our sister Christel was given the promise of eternal life in baptism. Keep her forever in your constant love and give her joy and communion with all your saints in light. Lord, in your mercy. Merciful God, your son wept at the death of his friend Lazarus. Look now with all your compassion on Christel's dear loved ones, family and friends in this time of their deep grief and pain and need. Grant them and all of us tender healing and peace of your steadfast love. Lord, in your mercy. God of salvation, we remember with thanksgiving all who have been part of our lives and who now live in the reality of the resurrection. Give each of us in our time left on earth hearts filled with faith, hope, and love, that we too could witness and live out the peace and joy that you would share with all your children and with all creation. Lord, in your mercy. God of all grace, you sent your Son, Jesus Christ, to bring life and immortality to light. We give you thanks that through his death, Jesus destroys the power of death, and by his resurrection has opened the kingdom of heaven to all who would believe. Help us to trust that because Christ lives, we shall live also, and that neither life nor death, nor things present nor things to come should be able to separate us from your love, which is in Christ Jesus our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Lord, lead us into your kingdom as you teach us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory, now and forever. Amen. This moment, I'd invite you to gather perhaps maybe one of your dear memories, picture of our sister Christel, and hold that in your heart as we prepare to give thanksgiving for her. And now we who have been loved by her and she by us, we commend this precious woman to the God who created her and gave her life, who gave her to us to love and to know. Let us pray. Into your hands, holy God, we commend our sister Christel. In this life, through the waters of baptism and beyond, you embraced her with your tender love. Now bid her to enter eternal rest. Welcome her into your paradise to be with all the saints who have gone before us, where there will be no more sorrow or weeping or pain, where she will enjoy the fullness of peace and joy in your presence forever and ever. Der Herr segne dich und behüte dich. Der Herr lasse leuchten sein Angesicht über dir und sei dir gnädig. Der Herr erhebe sein Angesicht auf dich und gebe dir Frieden. Amen. So as our time of worship here now comes to a close, again, once again, thank you to all the family and friends who have gathered around us in love to bring your support and prayers for this family. Much appreciated today, our pianist Hertha Pfeiffer from Trinity, a longtime friend of Christel's as well. We also want to thank Christ Lutheran Church here for hosting our gathering today, as well as the assistance given to us by Jeff Christensen and the folks at Spears Funeral Home. Also, for those who have ready dainties and coffee and refreshments for us, those are waiting for us as we'll be there in just a moment. And once we enter that space, there'll be memory cards and things like that on the table that we can continue to share some gifts with the family, to write out a story or some memories and leave those for us, and we will make sure that they get to Ron and the family as well. I'd invite you to stand as you're able to receive the final blessing for Christel and for us all. The Lord bless us and keep us. The Lord's face shine on us with grace and mercy. The Lord look upon us all with favor and grant us and Christel forever peace. Amen. Our closing hymn, How Great Thou Art, found in our service folders. Thank you.